Hey folks, what's up? Welcome back to our channel. Parenting 101, take care of the basic needs of your children. These parents got it all turned around where they are the ones being taken care of. What exactly did they do to get on this list? Keep watching. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos. Alright, now let's begin. Number 10. Bethany. Thinking about doing something and actually doing it are two very different things. Bethany's 18-year-old daughter does everything around the house, including, but not limited to, cooking, cleaning, groceries, etc. Bethany wants to help out, but she does not seem to do anything about it. Number 9. Ashley. Talk about priorities, Ashley does not take care of her newborn child and her 11-year-old daughter. In fact, it's the other way around. The older daughter is obliged to take care of the whole house at such a young age. Ashley makes herself a rich breakfast every morning and focuses more on her well-being. Number 8. James J.'s mother. In other news, this mother feeds her son so much that he is unable to eat anymore. This is her alternate version of making him eat healthy. She wants her son to live a healthy life, but that requires action rather than soppy promises. When she tags along to the first appointment, she's wearing a shirt which has hamburgers printed all over it. Number 7. Mila. Mila gets so mad when she does not get what she wants. Due to severe lymphedema, she hasn't left her bed for 2 years, and her husband can't help either. So who does take care of them? Unfortunately, the answer is her children. Even when she had a son, she wanted more kids and adopted a few given her obesity did not allow for a normal pregnancy. Her kids now wake up super early and clean her whole body, and even then she forces them to give her junk food. Number 6. Penny. Excuses, Penny tries to get out of putting effort into her weight loss journey by saying her son accepts her the way she is. Even when she clearly knows this is not the case and that a child needs his mother the most. She missed his kindergarten graduation, imagine that! Making fake promises to lose her weight, she continues to not act on those as usual. Number 5. Jean's mother. When I think of healthy food, salads come to mind. This is clearly not the case with Jean's mother. When she says that her family eats healthy, Dr. Now calls her out given the fact that she enabled her daughter to reach 700 pounds by giving her pizzas and burgers every day. There's no point of weight loss surgery unless the diet is balanced, which this family did not understand. Number 4. Pauline. When the roles reverse and children have to take care of their parents, that is just really sad. 50-year-old Pauline refuses to change even when she sees her son being clearly miserable in his life because she consumes all his time. He cooks, cleans, does the groceries, and everything. Number 3. James Bonner's mother. This woman keeps bringing his son food even when he does not ask for it. She claims feeling bad about stuffing their grocery shopping cart with unhealthy food, but brings it anyway. She needs to put her foot down, and instead she spreads the fire even more when she drinks beer in front of her son, who is a recovered alcoholic. Number 2. Ashley's son. How is this kid still with this woman? Where are the social services when you need them? Imagine a 5-year-old little boy doing laundry and other chores in the house. His mother is too blindsided to see what she is making her son do. He microwaves food and gives it to his mom because that is all they can manage to eat since the mother doesn't do anything. Number 1. Megan. I know mothers have this obsession with feeding their kids so they can be healthy, but this woman took it too far. She knew how bad her daughter Megan wanted to morph into a fit body, but she kept pushing her towards the wrong direction. She asked if Megan wanted bacon in her salad just as they were discussing her healthy diet after her meeting with Dr. Now. I'm not even heartbroken, I am straight up mad. This is completely unfair to these children. There are so many cases just like this which do not even make it to be on TV. Imagine how many children suffer at the hands of negligent parents. Well, this brings us to the end of our video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you haven't liked the video yet, it's never too late. Give it a thumbs up, people. We'll see you soon in another video. Until then, take care and goodbye.